A years-long investigation, the president's son, Hunter Biden, has reached a plea agreement with the U.S. Attorney's Office in Delaware. Hunter Biden set to plead guilty to two misdemeanor counts of failing to pay his taxes. The prosecutor is part of the deal, agreeing to recommend probation, no prison time. NBC's Kristen Welker joins us with details behind this plea agreement just filed that appears to wrap up the investigation into Hunter Biden. Kristen, good morning.
Hi, Savannah. Good morning to you. This is a five-year investigation that has now been wrapped up. And as you say, this is a Trump-appointed U.S. attorney for Delaware who has reached a plea agreement with Hunter Biden in which he is expected to plead guilty to two federal misdemeanor counts of failing to pay his taxes. Now, notably, he also faces a separate gun possession charge. That is likely going to be dismissed if he meets the conditions that have been hammered out under this agreement. We are getting a statement from the attorney from Hunter Biden who tells NBC News, quote, "With this announcement of two agreements between my client, Hunter Biden, and the United States Attorney's Office for the District of Delaware, it is my understanding that the five-year investigation into Hunter is resolved." Now, taking a step back here, Savannah, what is happening is that Hunter is not being charged with the potentially more serious allegations of potential criminal misconduct, business dealings, scrutiny of his business dealings with Chinese-owned businesses, Ukrainian businesses. This will undoubtedly become a political matter. Now, we are reaching out to, of course, the White House. We have not heard from the White House yet about this. President Biden has really not said a whole lot about this. He has argued that he wants to keep distance between himself and, of course, the Justice Department in this investigation. But notably, he did make some very recent comments in an interview with Stephanie Ruhle saying, quote, "My son has done nothing wrong. I trust him." Those comments will undoubtedly come under fresh scrutiny. Now, of course, this does come about a week after former President Trump pled not guilty to 37 counts that he mishandled classified documents. Republicans, the former president, have argued that there are two systems of justice here, one for him, one for Democrats. Of course, that is an argument that we have seen both Republicans and Democrats push back against. And the counterpoint that you'll undoubtedly hear in this case from Democrats will be that this is a Trump-appointed U.S. attorney. But again, a lot of scrutiny with this new development.
Well, there will be a lot of politics to discuss, but let's stay on this legal agreement that we just got word of. And I want to turn to Ken Delanian, who covers Justice Department for us. So Hunter Biden's attorneys are saying this is essentially a global resolution of this five-year-long investigation into Hunter Biden that looked at his taxes, this gun charge, but as Kristen referred to, also was scrutinizing business dealings that he had overseas, whether or not he had failed to register as a foreign agent, among other items. Is it your understanding that this investigation looked into those matters and has now concluded there are no charges forthcoming?
Good morning, Savannah. I certainly know from my own reporting that the investigation did look into those matters. And I guess the way to put it is we have no reason to doubt the on-the-record statement from Mr. Biden's attorneys that this resolution concludes the inquiry. As you know, NBC News reported that Hunter Biden received some $11 million from 2013 through 2018 for his work with a Ukrainian firm and a Chinese business person. And that work and some other issues are now the subject of investigations by congressional Republicans. But we also know that the Justice Department took a look at those issues. And if Hunter Biden's attorneys are to be believed, found no evidence of wrongdoing. And in fact, NBC News had previously reported that there was a felony tax charge on the table under consideration related to the improper use of a business expense. Obviously, the DOJ has decided not to bring that charge as part of this agreement, which is significant. That was the only felony tax charge we were aware of. And so what you have here are two misdemeanor charges about willful failure to pay taxes. And as Kristen said, this gun possession charge, possession of a gun by a user not entitled to possess one, which Mr. Biden is admitting to the facts of that charge, but will be entering a deferred adjudication, and that will be wiped off his record. So a significant legal victory for Mr. Biden in the sense that there is no jail time called for here. But at the same time, an admission of wrongdoing, even when, as Kristen said, his father has said very recently that his son did nothing wrong. So he is admitting to a crime here, but not a felony.
It's a guilty plea to a misdemeanor, two misdemeanor counts, and as mentioned, on the gun charge, which has to do with the paperwork you file when you try to purchase a gun. He was accused of falsifying that by not acknowledging a problem with addiction. Let me turn to Danny Savalos. Danny, you've seen many plea agreements. This one will come under close scrutiny, of course, because it regards the president's son, and now he's been given a plea agreement that allows him to plead guilty to misdemeanors only.